What's up, vapers? Nick here for Spin Fuel's Daily Vape TV. Today is Fresh Build Friday, and as always, we're going to be building a brand new coil. I have never tried this one before. It's going to be a little bit difficult for me, but I think you've all heard of it before. It's called the Stovetop Coil. This one's really unique in the sense that you wrap the wire around itself. I never tried it before, but I'm really looking to get into this one. So without further ado, let's go down to the close-up view and start building. All right, so as you can see here, we have all our tools laid out. The atomizer I'm going to be using today is the Still Air Clone. You'll need a small needle. This one is a 16 gauge. Other people use smaller needles, but this is the smallest one I have right now. So that's just the one I'm going to be using. I'll be using 24 gauge wire. So let's just start off by gripping the wire in between our thumb and forefinger on the edge of the tip of the needle here. And we'll start wrapping around the wire around itself. So we'll do the first wrap. You want to make sure these wraps are really tight too, so right up against the edge here. Just start wrapping right around itself. Alright, so here's our first stovetop coil. It's still a little bit sloppy, but we're going to clean it up once it's on our atomizer. As you can see, one of the leads goes from the center of the coil, and the other one just kind of goes out the side here. And that's really what I was shooting for. I will be making a dual coil today, so I'm just going to wrap another one of these real quick, and we'll install them on our RDA. There we go. We have two stovetop coils ready to go, so let's put them in our Still Air. So really nothing fancy about the installation. Just be careful with those coils because they do move around a lot, so just be gentle with them. And I'm just going to go ahead and clip these leads, straighten out the coils, and wick it. So as you can see, the resistance comes out to 0.3. Now let's put it on our mod and fire it up. Today I'll be using the Council of Vapor Kindred mod. It's a 18650 mechanical mod. So let's just go ahead. We got her on top here. Let's see how she fires. Thank you. All right, so here I have some Japanese cotton. Let's just take off a little strip here. You want to keep it as fluffy as possible. And basically what we're going to do is just pack it all in behind the coil itself and then just make a little cloud underneath. Here you can see we're all wicked up, and this style of wicking is a lot like the dragon wick method because it goes like around the coil, but in this case the coil goes the same direction, so we're just going to leave it completely wide open on one side and just pack in the cotton behind it so the coil still gets air, but all the juice is going to be stored behind the coil itself. So let's go ahead and juice it up, and today I'll be using some high voltage vapors. Their flavor is Short Circuit. It is a melon with cream and berries. Smells delicious, so I can't wait to try it. All right. Moment of truth. Let's see the vapor production. Woo! That smells delicious. Let's go back to the main screen and have a vape. This thing is absolutely chucking. Let's have a quick vape and then we'll talk about it. As you can see, this thing is chucking the vapor. Very shocked at how much vapor you get out of it considering the wicking method. You would think that with the wick packed in behind the coil like that, you're not going to get any airflow through the actual atomizer, but considering the heat on this thing builds up on one side so much, and you get the direct airflow onto the coil, I think that's really where it comes from. I haven't really gotten too many dry hits out of it. After, you know, 5 or 6 pulls, you got to re-drip it, but you don't really need to do huge pulls with this thing. About 2 to 3 seconds and you're good to go. As for the flavor, I'm getting really deep, dense notes of all the berries, cream, and with a nice melon finish of this juice. So as for the flavor production of this coil, I'm a big fan of that. Let's take another vape real quick. So as I just said, I get a lot of really great flavor out of this coil. It's a little bit difficult on other builds to get the cream flavor to come out, but on this one it's definitely there, so I'm enjoying that. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check out www.spinfuel.com for lots more of my videos, as well as the Vapor Trail channel and Smokin' Joey. Stay tuned for next week's Fresh Build Friday, and as always, vape on!